name is Renato Amorim, and I'm a lecturer here at TASMAC, teaching business statistics.
We have a big population, let's say, all persons in the UK, or all students in this class, and then we choose a sample, a subpart, a small part of this population.
Well, my teaching background, I've been teaching in the UK for about 4 to 5 years. I also teach in a couple of other universities, University of Hertfordshire and University of Bedfordshire. I hold a PhD in data mining. Data mining, to those of you who do not know, is basically about this, about you getting a huge amount of data and trying to make conclusions about this. My PhD I did at Birkbeck University of London.
Maybe you have seen on TV some statistics like Mr. A has 55% of votes. How do you think they found that Mr. A has 55% of votes? Do you think they went to every single person in the country and asked, who are you going to vote for? Who are you going to vote for? Probably not, isn't it? Why not? It would be extremely expensive, okay? There are some people that live in London, there are people that live in the countryside, there are people that live in Scotland, North Ireland. So it would be very expensive, isn't it? What else?
Time consuming.
Time consuming, isn't it? It would be next to impossible to do that in 1 month. Okay, so the whole point is that it is just unfeasible, isn't it? So what do people actually do? They get a sample.
In every single dissertation, one thing you're going to have to do is called data analysis. And that's what the subject is about. It's about you being able to get a data set and making reasonable conclusions about this data set. Again, so you can make whatever business decision you may need to do.
You have your population, and you have, let's say, your sample is easier. And you hope that this sample is going to represent the whole.
We use statistics every single day. If you just have a look in any British newspaper, or I'm sure any newspaper in the world, you're going to see that things are always set in statistical terms. For instance, if you're talking about the London Stock Exchange or any exchange in the world, you're going to find out that every single time that it increases or decreases is always about a certain amount, a certain percentage. And for instance, in this case, another thing that we do in statistics is attempt to forecast things. In other words, attempt to predict if something is going to happen or not.
So, in this, I'm going to go to that formulas in a minute, and this is what we show here, isn't it? See, I have Mr. A, 18 years old, B, 20, C, 22 years old, and D, 24. And every single one of them has a chance of 25% or 0.25, isn't it? That's the probability. And that is why this distribution here looks like a square, isn't it? And when the distribution looks like this, I mean, everybody is about the same, we call this a uniform distribution.
Can we actually use quantitative methods such as statistics to improve business decisions? So in a nutshell, the point is that instead of you just making decisions based on your guts, you actually use a statistical tool to see what is actually happening in the business environment, and then you make your business decisions.
So how do I calculate this standard deviation? It is the square root of this summation, isn't it, divided by the total. But then let's do this step by step. Again, in the exam, if you have something very big to calculate, do it step by step so you have a higher chance of getting it right.
Well, the one advice would be what I have in my very first slide. Do not panic. Yeah? We are here to help you. I mean, a number of students are slightly afraid because it is a quantitative subject. So we do have numbers everywhere, formulas everywhere. But myself, just like any other lecturer in TASMAC, is here just to help. So if people have any problem, come to us. Our objective is to make sure that you guys understand everything you need to understand.